Hi friends, welcome back on our YouTube channel. This is the next lecture of quantum mechanics, in which today we will discuss about experimental confirmation of de Broglie's hypothesis. In this lecture we will discuss about Davison and Germer's experiment, and also we will discuss about G.P. Thomson experiment. So first of all, Davison and Germer's experiment. So Davison, Germer's experiment. Now this is our experimental arrangement. In this figure, F is a filament made of tungsten. So this is our filament which is made up of tungsten. The electrons are accelerated from filament on heating it by a low tension battery. Since filament is connected to a low tension battery, so on heating it, the electrons are accelerated from this filament. G is an anode containing a fine hole. So this is our anode. It has a fine hole so that the electrons accelerated from this filament passes through anode on this crystal. C is a nickel crystal. The electrons are strike on this crystal and then accelerated in all possible directions. So electrons which accelerated from this filament falls on this nickel crystal and they scattered by this crystal in all possible directions. D is a detector which can be rotated on a circular scale S, and this detector is used to measure the intensity of electrons accelerated by C. So this is our detector. This detector can be rotated on this circular turntable, and this detector is used to measure the intensity of electrons which scattered by this nickel crystal. Phi is an angle between the incident electron beam on crystal and the scattered direction of electron. So incident electron beam is this one, and the electrons which scattered by this nickel crystal will go in this direction. So phi is an angle between the incident electron beam and the electrons scattered by this nickel crystal. If we plot a graph between phi and I, that is intensity of scattered electron beam by crystal at different V. So if you plot a graph between intensity and this angle at different value of potential which we give to this anode, so the curve will be like this. So at 42 volt, if you plot a graph between I and phi, then this will be like this. And at 48 volt, we get this kink here, and this kink will be maximum at the potential 54 volt. So if potential is 54 volt and we draw a graph between I and phi, then this kink will be maximum. And if we increase the potential after 54 volt, then this again starts to decrease. Now, conclusion. So, this was our diagram. It means intensity I depends on angle phi. There is always a bump or kink occurs in the curve at phi equal to 50 degree. So, if phi equal to 50 degree, then we get this kink or bump. As the value of accelerating voltage V increases, the size of bump increases. The bump becomes maximum at V equal to 54 volt. On further increasing the value of V, bump starts to decrease. So as we increase the value of V, this bump starts to increase and it becomes maximum at 54 volt. And after 54 volt, if we increase this potential, then again this bump starts to decrease. Now, according to de Broglie, wavelength lambda equal to 12.27 divided by root V in terms of angstrom, and here V equal to 54 volt, because at 54 volt the bump or kink becomes maximum. So here we use V equal to 54 volt. So lambda equal to 12.27 divided by root 54 is equal to 1.67 angstrom. So if V equal to 54 volt, then the wavelength will be 1.67 angstrom. And from Bragg's law, 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. So 2d sin theta equal to n lambda is our Bragg's law. Here n is the order of diffraction, d is the interplanar distance, and theta is the glancing angle of diffraction. For X-ray analysis, nickel works as plane diffraction grating, so it will provide the diffraction pattern. And for nickel crystal, D111 is equal to 0.91 angstrom. So here we put 0.91 angstrom. So this was our diagram. The electron beam incident from this direction on nickel crystal, and it is scattered in different directions. So this angle is phi, which is 50 degree. Now theta plus phi plus theta is equal to 180 degree. It means 2 theta plus phi equal to 180 degree, but phi equal to 50 degree. So here diffraction angle phi equal to 50 degree. So glancing angle theta equal to 180 minus 50 upon 2, that is 65 degree, because 2 theta plus phi equal to 180 degree. So theta equal to 180 minus 50 upon 2. So theta equal to 180 minus 50 upon 2, that is 65 degree. Now we put d equal to 0.91 and theta equal to 65 degree, and also for first order diffraction n equal to 1. So from 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda, we get 2 into 0.91 sin 65 degree is equal to 1 into lambda. So from this equation we get lambda equal to 1.65 angstrom. So this is from Bragg's law. And from Davison Germer experiment, we get lambda equal to 1.67 angstrom. So the excellent agreement between the two results for lambda. One result is obtained from Davison-Germer's experiment and another from Bragg's law. And these two results are found to be in excellent agreement. So the excellent agreement between the two results for lambda confirms de Broglie's hypothesis for electrons. It means the electron beam of energy 54 electron volt at 50 degree angle possesses a strong diffraction, which shows the wave nature, and nickel crystal works as diffraction grating, because when V equal to 54 volt, then the kink will be maximum at 50 degree. So the electron beam of energy 54 electron volt at 50 degree possesses a strong diffraction and it shows the wave nature, and nickel crystal in this case works as diffraction grating. Now our next experiment is G.P. Thomson experiment. So G.P. Thomson experiment, it also shows the wave nature of electron beam. Now this is our experimental arrangement of G.P. Thomson experiment. Here F is a filament which emits electron beam by heating it using a battery. So this is our filament and this filament is connected to a battery. So this filament is heated by using this battery. So the electron beam accelerates from this filament. A is an anode on which a positive potential about 10^4 to 10^5 volt is applied. So electrons are attracted towards it. So this is our anode and we provide positive potential to this anode, and this positive potential is about 10^4 to 10^5 volt, so that the electrons which accelerated from this filament attract towards this anode. B is a small aperture or block. So this is our block or a small aperture. And G is a gold foil. So this is our gold foil and electron falls on this gold foil. P is a photographic plate. So this is our photographic plate and this whole apparatus is enclosed in an evacuated chamber. The fringe pattern obtained on photographic plate has dark center. So electron beam falls on gold foil and after scattering from this gold foil, it falls on photographic plate and we get fringe pattern on photographic plate, and the fringe pattern obtained on photographic plate has dark center. This is our fringe pattern which we obtained on photographic plate. If this experiment is repeated in the absence of gold foil, then no fringe pattern is observed. So if we repeat this experiment in the absence of gold foil, then there will be no fringe pattern. Thus, fringe pattern is due to the gold foil. It confirms that the electron beam shows the wave nature and these waves diffract from the gold foil and provide a diffraction pattern which we get on the photographic plate. Thomson determined the crystal lattice spacing d for electron of known frequency by measuring the diameter of these rings. He also determined the value of d, that is interplanar distance, by de Broglie's equation. Since the difference between the two results for X-rays is only about 1%, so it verified the de Broglie's hypothesis for electrons. So here we end our session. In the current session, we have studied about the experimental confirmation of de Broglie's phenomena, and as an evidence of this phenomena, we use Davison and Germer's experiment and also G.P. Thomson experiment. So goodbye.